Hello and welcome to the online tutorial for Google Classroom. Google Classroom is a learning management system which offers robust features for students and instructors. We need to understand that Google Classroom actually supplements the classroom rather than recreates it. So the entire focus is on extending certain but not all components of the classroom to online. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create a classroom, how to connect your students, the different kinds of material that you can actually upload on Google Classroom, and the most important part, which is assessment. So even though that you are not meeting the students face to face, you can create a very robust mechanism where you can actually assess the students. And in fact, you can also have a grading system and add a rubric as well. So let's dive in and learn more about Google Classroom.
The best way to actually to go to Google Classroom is if you're already in your Gmail account. So if you're logged into any of the Google apps, you can directly go to Google Classroom. So say for example, you are in any of these apps from Google, you can scroll down and you'll find the classroom. But the other way, and probably the fastest way, is to just type classroom.google.com. So if you're already logged in, you'll be taken straight to your home page of Google Classroom. Now, as you can see, I've already created all these different classrooms. But I'm going to start showing you from scratch. So you click on this plus icon right here, and you can see there are two options, join class and create class. So if you're a student, then obviously you have to click on join class, but that's not what we're exploring. This particular tutorial is for instructors. So I'm going to click on create class. Now you get a message from Google saying if your school or university has a package with Google through G Suite, you can choose that option. But since we are working independently here, we can just click on I have read the above notice and click on continue. And immediately you are asked to create a class name. So I'm going to add the class, which is for my MA course, MA semester 4, techniques of editing. If you want to create different sections, you can actually create that. But I have very less students, so I'm not going to create any new sections. Here I'm going to add the code of my subject and I'm going to click on create. So the class gets created and you can see that it has its own code. This code you can actually use to share with your students so that they can join the class, or you can directly add them to your class, whichever you may feel is easier for you. The first thing I would like to do is actually to create a welcome message. So I have already written something, just copy from that and paste here. So I'm just going to paste it here. And if you want to add, you can actually add a Google Drive link. Suppose you have a syllabus, you can add your syllabus here. You have a Dropbox link where you want to add the syllabus, you can do that. You can also upload a file. If you have a video link also, you can also add it here. I have none, so I'm just have this text as my welcome address, and I'm going to post it. So this got posted to my class. Whoever joins this class will see this welcome address. Now let me explain to you. There are four different tabs here on top, which has very specific things that it does. The first one is coursework. The coursework is great for creating assignments, your topics. So say for example, I'm planning this course for next 4 weeks. I can actually create a topic and I can divide the topic into 4 weeks. Or suppose you want to have, you know, divide them as per topic, you can also do that. You also can create assignments, quiz assignments, a specific question, and you can obviously create the material which they can go through for each particular topic. So first let me create a topic, and I want to create a topic called history of film editing. That is the first thing that I want them to do. So I'll create a topic. The topic gets created. As you can see right now, there are no information. It is just a topic. And you can see all the topics are actually listed here on the left. Now let me create some kind of material. Now the material I want to create is actually a reading list. And I've already I've already created a content for that. So I want history of film editing. So I'm gonna, just going to paste it here. And as far as the description is concerned, as per my timetable, I take this class on Tuesday. So I can specify a date and time so people can log in, read the material, and they can submit an answer to my questions, which will mark as an attendance. That's the best way to actually inculcate some kind of interactivity with the students as far as your class is concerned. So now I have the reading list right here. So I have this particular videos which I want to share, and I have this reading list. So this is my Pinterest. I have created a topic called film editing in this as a section in my overall board called video and film production. I can just copy this particular link, come back to my class, and I can share the link here. I also have few videos which I want them to go through. So I can actually select this link, come back to my classwork, add a YouTube video. And this one I can choose by typing a URL. And the moment I edit, the preview comes and I can add it. So I have one video. I have another video as well, which is a crash course in the film editing. So I'll come back to classroom, add YouTube, and go to URL, paste it, and add it. That's how easy it is. If you want to have any kind of handout you want to share, you can share this as a PDF. As I mentioned earlier, you can also give a link to Dropbox or any other URL that you have. And if you're using Google Drive, you can share a link from Google Drive as well. Now that's my topic. Now this, I will choose for this specific topic. So this material is going to this particular topic, which I've created earlier. And this is going to all this particular batch of students, which are my MA students, who are doing this course in film editing, and post. Okay, so you can see there's already a new material here. I can now actually add a question because I want them to answer this question once they come and read the material. This is for all the MA fourth semester students. If you want, you can give a marks for giving this answer, or I'm going to choose unmarked. As for the date is concerned, I'm going to choose, and my time is at 11 p.m. So that's more than enough time for them to actually submit this particular answer. I'm going to click on ask, and I'm going to go back to my classwork. So you can see all my questions and my topics are here. I can go to people and I can add a teacher. Suppose I'm sharing this subject with someone, I can add a teacher here. And I can also, I can add my students by typing the email address, or I can share them this particular code. They can use this code to actually join in the class, as I showed earlier in the very beginning, that you can join a class by using a code. This is for marks. So if I have marked, or have any kind of marked assignment, I can use this to basically give marks to my students based on what submissions they are putting in. Now that's how it looks like. You can give it more, you can personalize your layout by choosing a theme or uploading a new picture. But that's pretty much how you can create a class and add materials and add questions and make it an interactive class with your students. Now let me show you some of my other classes so I can explain to you and show you how things look like. For example, just today I conducted a class on film, and this is my class. This is the code that I have shared with my students, and this is the classwork that I have created for my students. I have actually given them a particular reading list, which is a film movement, which is Italian neorealism. I have given them a particular question which they need to answer. As you can see, out of my class of 40 students, 32 has actually handed in the assignment. Tomorrow they have this film that they need to watch. They can download the film. I've added a Dropbox link. They can download the film. And I have also added a pop quiz, okay, as per this particular film screening. So that's how my existing class looks like. I can go to people and I can see all the students who have logged in and who have a part of my class here. As I mentioned to you that I have given them this assignment, so I can actually show you how it looks like. So if I click on this and I open the submission panel, you can see that all these people have actually submitted my assignment, and I can see here that the following people have not submitted the assignment. Even if they submit now, it will be showing as handed in, and there will be a small text which say that late submission, so I'll know people who have actually submitted my assignment late. The best part is that you can actually the students here, they have actually uploaded a PDF document to answer my question. I didn't ask them to do that, but they have an option. They can either type in a simple text or they can actually upload a file. So say, let me, for example, open this new window when I click on it, and you can see that I can see the PDF right here. So I don't have to download it. I don't have to open it in a separate window. It opens right here. The best part about this is that all this is going to your Google Drive. So which means that all the files that you're getting as a submission is going to your Google Drive, and you will always have an access to it. I can see the name. I can see what they have submitted. And I can also send them a private comment as well. So which means you can interact with your students and can give them feedback as they submit your assignments. Let me come out of this window and show you something else. I have another class which I've been taking, and that is this one. And this class is a class called Digital Film Production Technique. And in this class, you can see that I have given them a topic and they have given them a question as well. And as you can see, 11 people have actually given me the answer to my question. And this is how it looks like. So these are students who have not uploaded a file, but actually just left comments. And I have tried to comment and reply to each student, and they have replied back to me. And this creates a great opportunity for to us as a faculty to have an interaction with your student, and based on what answers they are giving, and you can have a live interaction. Google Classroom also lets you create a discussion room as well. So you can create a discussion room for your students, and you can share this code, and they can connect to the discussion room, and you can have a live discussion with your students as well. So that's basically it for today. I'm also learning this tool, and my colleagues at Mahe Dubai are also learning this tool. So as and when I get to know new things, I will definitely share those tips. And we expect you to use this tool efficiently and have a lively discussion with the students using Google Classroom. Thank you.